So the music describes the panorama from Picton Point. Firstly, gazing up the Eastern River from the horizon with a few flashes of light on the water. The eye is then drawn to the main channel, and it climaxes in the middle at the confluence, and then on to the Western River and the way to the vanishing point. Crafty Woods on the banks of the Eastern Cheltenham River is one of the few remaining fragments of the oak forests which once covered the whole of Pembrokeshire, and it's an important haven for wildlife. The music describes pathways meandering through a deserted wood. Unlike Picton Point and Crafty Woods, Picton Castle is at the centre of the community. It's 13th century Norman and was inhabited by the same family right through to the end of the 20th century. It's now looked after by a trust. My parents moved there in 1952, when they were in their 20s, and I was a bump. I was born there a few months later. My father was head gardener under the redoubtable Lady Marion Phillips. She had the interest and the finance, and he had the vision to create a spectacular woodland garden that continues to attract thousands of visitors every year, and now a steady trickle of recorder players, which is lovely, including a member of the orchestra here who went last week. My parents were absolutely at the centre of village life. My father was chairman for the carnival committee for Queen Elizabeth's coronation. My mum was guide captain. Then there was youth club, concert party, cricket matches, all sorts of things, chapel anniversary. So Picton Castle starts with a fanfare, leading to a parody of popular marches from the 1950s. The slower middle section represents my father's beautiful gardens, and the final section is the bustle of village life. I'm sorry to say that my mum died sadly last December at the grand old age of 97, but my father, who's the same age, is here today for this performance of Picton.